All right, in the tasting room at Best Wines. And, you know, we are constantly taken aback by the people that swing by because, you know, in the world of wine, there's people that are rock stars and there's people that are going to be rock stars. And, you know, we're really fortunate to have a rock star in the making here with us this afternoon. Audrey Bracini, the winemaker. Said it perfect, yeah. Yeah, and the winemaker at Domaine Ferré in Pouilly-Fouissé. And I know a lot of you have seen Pouilly-Fouissé on bottles of wine before. You know, the house of Louis Jadot made Pouilly-Fouissé ubiquitous throughout French bistros in America, starting in the 70s, moving onwards as the high-end French Chardonnay pour at many of the top restaurants throughout the country decades ago. But in fact, you know, Pouilly-Fouissé is so much more than that. And I think that's one of the reasons why the House of Jadot purchased Domaine Ferré back in 2008, because they knew, even though they make a lot of Pouilly-Fouissé and sell it throughout the world, they knew that Pouilly-Fouissé was so much more than that. And we are tickled pink to have Audrey here talking about the wines today. The House of Jadot was smart enough to hire Audrey to do the winemaking and carry on the tradition at Domaine Ferré. Audrey, you know, it says Pouilly-Fouissé on the label, and we know that the wine is 100% Chardonnay. Now, but beyond that, what makes Pouilly-Fouissé so special and so unique in the world of Burgundy wine?
It's a very good question. Mm. You're right, at the beginning, say Pouilly-Fouissé were parents pauvres of the south of Burgundy, but in fact, Pouilly-Fouissé and Fouissé in particular is probably the most complex area of all the big Burgundy when you speak about the soil.
Ah.
So first, did make it really unique. And the other thing, make that Pouilly-Fouissé is not only a wine that you have to drink easily, very quick. In fact, we have forgotten our history. Because if we come back to some books from the 18th, 19th century and the century before, there are very great writers who have said that Pouilly-Fouissé and some places on the east-facing slope can be great red wines, such as Meursault, Pouilly, and this we have forget. During the war, the two roads of the North Burgundy and the South of Burgundy changed, mm-hmm. really. In the North, they have Premier Cru, because they have to keep the wine, because of the German people, only little whites can be catched by them.
Oh, really?
Yes, and they have to classify, to have a law, because before, in 1861, they have information with their best plots, and they can in 1942 they can put the name Premier Cru, in fact, for these plots. And after, in 1943, there was a law where they was obliged to have Premier Cru to keep this wine. And in fact, in the south of the Burgundy, in Mâconnais area, it was a free area. So don't choose to have Premier Cru to keep the wine.
There was no need because they were able to keep everything protected from the Germans.
You're right. And after, when the war was finished, the road changed because the structure were different in the north and in the sud, Mâconnais.
Mm-hmm.
So they think to everything we have more blend.
Mm.
And it's just since 2006, 2007, that the producer finally said, but we are great wines too. We have great wines too.
Mm.
And we have really to show and to explain and to have Premier Cru, maybe in few years.
Yeah. Well, you know, Domaine Ferré continued. Domaine Ferré kind of remembered 1943, didn't they, with regards to how they set up the wines, because, you know, in front of us today, we just have the it's a hell of a wine. The straight 2010 Pouilly-Fouissé from Ferré, but Ferré came up with their own unique system to designate the top vineyards. in Pouilly-Foussay, because there's definitely kind of like an unspoken Grand Cru and Premier Cru system already in place in Pouilly-Foussay, correct?
You're right. And Madame Ferré was an avant-gardiste person. Uh-huh. She made film before the other, and you're right. 50 years before, she made the classification finally. She had tête de cru, premier cru, and cuvée hors classe, our grand cru.
Yeah.
She made this, and she was someone who tastes very well, and she find these great plots. You're right.
Yeah, absolutely. So when you taste through the lineup of single vineyard wines from Ferré, just remember that the tête de cru is like the premier cru wines,
yes,
and the hors classé are the grand cru wines from these vineyards. And you watch when, because the classification will come down for Pouilly-Foussay. It will have this. They will have their own designations within Pouilly-Foussay coming shortly. And you watch which ones end up where. And I think Madame Ferré was very keen and had this business all figured out a long time ago. So that being said, we talked about Jadot purchasing Ferré. And Jadot's a big house, right? Jadot makes a lot of wine. How did the sale to Louis Jadot impact the quality of the wines at the Domaine, or the style, if at all?
It's a good question, in fact, and it's normal that you think to this question. In fact, Mr. Pierre-Henri Gaget and Mr. Jacques Lardière, they know very well Domaine Ferré, Mr. Ferré. They bought most for a very long time, and when they became the owner, they made all the thing with a lot of respect, and they really want to keep the tradition of the wine and to continue with the same spirit. Yes, they want that Domaine Ferré, as it were, continue to live, really.
Yeah.
So even if there is the great big house Maison Louis Jadot, they know that it's so important to keep the domain as it was. Yes.
Yeah, because they know the importance and the relevance of the domain.
Yes.
Yeah.
You're right.
My gosh. So let's talk about the wine in front of us. This is the 2010 Pouilly-Foussay. So is this wine a blend of some of these tête de cru and hors classé parcels, or is it separate parcels from the estate? Or
it's a good question. In fact, for this cuvée, it's for a part some tête de cru and cuvée hors classe, sure, and for another part, plots all around Fuissé Amphitheater. So some comes from the part with the granitic subsoil, which gives the wine the freshness, the crisp of the wine, and some comes from the east facing slope, not so far from our tête de cru and hors classe cuvée. And this cuvée will give the structure to the wine. So
the complete package, the whole nine yards. You know, if you've never had this wine, you know, the wines of Ferré, they have this fabulous contrast between this rich, almost honeyed, exotic fruit component that's just so luscious and so beautiful. At the same time, there's this crazy focus to the wine. So even though you the wine has this intensity of flavor, at the same time, the wine cuts so clean. And believe me, this is very hard to do. And Audrey, she's got it wired. You know, the fact that you can have this much richness and this exotic nature in a Chardonnay, because it's what it is, 100% Chardonnay, of this stature, but at the same time, maintain the focus and intensity and the sneaky acidity and structure that comes into this wine. I think it's just, like we said, the complete package. So if you've never had the opportunity to try a Pouilly-Foussay from Domaine Ferré, you have to remember that you're drinking some history here. They are, without a doubt, one of the top, if not the top producer in Pouilly-Foussay. And the House of Jadot, along with Audrey, is carrying on this legacy. And we have not seen a skip a beat. We've been tasting the wines for 15 years, 20 years, and my gosh, they are just as good, if not better, than ever. So thank you, Audrey. This wine's absolutely sensational. Stupid good. And if you get a chance to taste some of the single vineyard bottlings, you should do that as well. You owe it to yourself, because they are some of the greatest Chardonnay experiences you could ever have from Burgundy. Cheers.